We're back to action here on WCW Pro Wrestling. Cruz the Dream and the Legend. And gentlemen, we have got a main event here. The American Male, the former World Tag Team Champion, going up against, hey, believe it or not, the former World Tag Team Champions in the Stud Stable, Bunkhouse Buck and Dirty Dick Slater and Dusty. Since you seem to be the matrimonial expert here, Colonel Parker and Sherry preparing for matrimony at the Clash.
Well, I said that, and big doings are going on, as you said, matrimony there. But right now, he needs to focus these guys on Larry, the American Male, because the American Male's going to start out 96, regaining the World Tag Team title.
Well, everybody wants to climb to that ladder of success, and nobody wants to climb there more than Dirty Dick Slater and Bunkhouse Buck. And I don't think they need the help from the Colonel. Bunkhouse Buck, Dirty Dick, tons of experience here. I think if they just stay focused on the males, they should have no problem. Colonel Parker's the one with the problem.
Why do you say that?
His life is going to be ending soon, as we know it. I can hardly keep from laughing myself.
Here they go, man, the American Males.
Ah, to be young, have lots of hair, lots of muscles, good looks, and athleticism.
It feels good, I guarantee
you. No, you know what? I'm talking about the American Males.
Time to get dirty!
Marcus Alexander Beckwell and Scotty Riggs. And Riggs, as of late, has been displaying an incredible prowess with that dropkick.
Well, these guys are trying, but the proof is in the pudding, and we'll see who winds up eating the pudding.
Right here, but I'll tell you what, you know, WCW Pro Arena, while we got a second right here, one more time, I want to remind them, we talked about it so long, and Larry picked the Nature Boy Ric Flair to win tonight on WCW Saturday Night against the one and only Macho Man Randy Savage. I believe Macho Man Randy Savage got something to prove, and tonight we're going to set it on fire on Saturday night right here on TBS.
The U.S. title on the line as well. Kensuke Sasaki takes on the one-man gang. And earlier here on the Pro, we saw part one of that special interview with Mike Ditka. Tonight, part two.
Yeah, and a very interesting interview with Hulk Hogan and the Macho Man Randy Savage. Also, the Nature Boy Ric Flair and the Giant going to be talking about it. And they seem to be in bed with each other. If you know what I'm talking about right here, two different people that are fighting against each other, Dungeon of Doom, going against the one and only Four Horsemen.
We'll also see Eddie Guerrero, Alex Wright, and these two individuals, the American Males. I don't know. Can we fit all that in one program? It's tonight on WCW Saturday Night. We'll try to get it all in.
That'd have been a headlock.
And a top wrist lock there on Dirty Dick Slater, known universally as one of the toughest men to ever step foot inside a wrestling ring. Both of you gentlemen have faced him, and I think you would concur. And Bagwell turns right into it, unfortunately for him. And now the whip in this main event here on the Pro. And Bagwell picks up Dirty Dick with a nice body slam. And he does the same to Bunkhouse Buck. Oh, Slater does the smart thing, backs right off.
Well, Slater was trying to come in, but he noticed Bagwell saw him, so he backed off. I mean, Bagwell rigs very fast, but that's not going to throw Dick Slater off here. This guy, I guess you could define him as a brawler with science. He knows what he's doing in there. He just assumed punch in the mouth and take you down. But in the case of Bagwell, there you go. That's what I was thinking. Take him down on the mat, Dick, but don't put your head in the wrong place.
There you go, Marcus. See there, just counter. When you counter one move with another great move, this is what happened. The American Males, I'm going to tell you what, they are looking forward to this match. I talked to them before, and they said, man, we got to prove ourselves in this Pro Arena this morning here on TBS.
A chop there by Slater on the wide open Marcus Alexander. Bagwell, look out! Now the inside cradle. Bagwell's just got one.
Now he didn't have no, he had one leg bundled up, and that wasn't enough. And look at Slater. He backs right off to that corner, hoping Bagwell may run into him, but Bagwell didn't. Almost got distracted by Mr. Parker.
You know, as we watch this tag team main event this morning here on the Pro, we're reminded that the Clash will feature three tag team matches. Hulk Hogan and Macho Man Randy Savage take on Ric Flair and the Giant. Sting and Lex Luger against the Blue Bloods, and the Nasty Boys against a brand new team of the Public Enemy. Possibly the best clash in the history of World Championship Wrestling, and that is saying a whole lot. Bagwell now with a shoulder block football tackle and moves right in. And in comes Scotty Riggs.
Headlock.
For the first time.
Headlock.
I'm not sure. And Buck knew that Scotty Riggs had been tagged in. He knows now.
He found out the hard way.
Standing side headlock, and Scotty Riggs gets the big man down. How lanky, how lean and long Bunkhouse Buck is. Probably 6'7", 6'8", and Riggs only about, well, I say only about 6'2".
All right,
standing
there.
Side headlock there by Bunkhouse Buck.
There you go, Bunk.
And the fans getting into it. Look at the spring, and there it is. There's that drop kick. It can finish you off with that. Scotty Riggs, oh, a clothesline right over the top rope, inadvertent, and Colonel Parker claiming that that should be a disqualification.
Hey!
See, the people talking that Colonel Parker isn't focused, it's going to have to make the difference with him. Colonel Parker, he snuck one in there. Referee was out of position. Now they got Riggs where they want him, down on the mat in their corner.
And Dusty, I think it's now time for you to say that Dirty Dick Slater stumping a mud hole.
Well, obviously, Christopher Cruz, I will say that when it actually happened, not after the fact, you know.
And, I get you.
Yeah.
Ouch, that
good
hurts.
Headbutt right there. And Larry's so right, you know, the American males, their whole offensive agenda should be quick tags in and out to stay out of trouble. But they're in trouble now.
Yeah, and Dirty Dick Bunkhouse Buck, they are not going to let Riggs out of this corner. They have anything to say about it. Now these guys will take advantage of the young and the useless here.
There you goes go. Scotty Riggs, and my guess is Colonel Parker is somewhere nearby. Oh, so close.
Hey, ref, turn around. Look at this. Hey, ref!
This is a man who is prepared to take his wedding vows. You think he'd have some self-respect? You think he maybe once play fair? Apparently not.
I think Sister Sherry's the kind. She wants a real man. And Parker, he better be aggressive.
And Scotty Riggs is doing everything he can to fight his way out of this. He's up and over. Bunkhouse Buck trying to hang on. He tags Dirty Dick Slater. Riggs doesn't know it. He knows now. A pull of the hair there by, look out for your face.
Boy, just ramming that boot down there. These guys know the importance of control, maintaining it. Right there, look at Dick Slater playing that game of chess with Bagwell. Got him frustrated. Bagwell comes in, only pulling the referee out of position. And that's Dirty Dick's plan here.
Yeah, well, Bagwell's got to understand that he is part of the plan. He's been around long enough to know don't get caught in the Dick Slater plan, because if he does, it backfires on him. And Slater got that leg hooked up there. A lot of pressure. Could break that thing. Somehow Riggs got to get over and make that tag, guys.
Indeed he does, because he's surely getting punished right now by Dirty Dick Slater this morning here on the main event on WCW Pro on TBS. And a straight right that rocks Dirty Dick. A second one rocks him again, and then a kick there, but his left leg may be limp, lifeless, and useless.
But he made the tag, though. Riggs is nowhere near tagging Bagwell.
No, they've got him in an injured-prone position, as you said, and keeping him over there. And they part of town. Here you go, baby.
Some momentum is Bunkhouse Buck, and Riggs ducks. Oh, and he ducks again. What a smart move by Scotty Riggs.
He's to make the tag, Chris.
And he's got it right in front of the referee. And watch Bagwell explode with rights.
Oh, he nailed Slater. He nailed him again.
Bagwell taking care of Slater and Bunkhouse Buck. What strength by Marcus Alexander Bagwell. And look out.
She doesn't look happy.
The bride-to-be has made her entrance here in the WCW Pro Arena. Bagwell goes for the cover. It's blocked by Dirty Dick Slater. Scotty Riggs is in. The wild card now is Sister Sherry.
The crowd is chanting Sherry.
Well, I'll tell you what, got the sleeper on Buck, but Sherry's out there. The first lady of Bucksnock, Tennessee, soon to be. But Bunkhouse hasn't seen her yet. You know what I mean? He's doing business here. Uh-oh.
And now look at him. He's totally distracted in the sleeper. Sister Sherry.
Oh, stand by. Stand by your man.
Oh, what is that?
What's that noise?
Uh-oh. Boy, they got a domestic problem going on here.
Parker's insane!
This is truly a domestic problem.
And now Parker says, I believe that I have overstepped my bounds here. I've let my alligator mouth get my butterfly body in trouble.
How is the Parker's going to get a wife and a bodyguard all built into one?
All right, we're looking forward to the clash of the champions when finally this union will be made in front of God and all wrestling fans throughout the world. Sister Sherry and Colonel Parker to get married, a clash of champions. We're back with a pro in a moment.
This portion of WCW Pro Wrestling is brought to you by Lawnmower Man 2. God made him simple. Science made him a god. Now he wants revenge. Rated PG-13.